fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree. We can rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. We safely walk to school without a sound. Well, here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniforms from chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell. Nouns and books and show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball. Then back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. The teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass, 'cause we don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. The teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes it when you sing. Tonight I'll dream in my bed while silly thoughts run through my head of the bugs and alphabet. And when I wake tomorrow, I'll bet you and I will walk together again. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
When you come to fifth grade, you should expect a little more responsibility on your behavior, more responsibility with your classwork, and mostly you should expect to have a whole lot more fun.
So in fifth grade social studies, kids should expect to have a great fun and a good time, because we are doing some of the most incredible studies. We study the ancient cultures, and then we study the explorers, then we study settlements and the colonies, and we go right into the Revolutionary War. It's a long period of time, but it's a lot of fun.
So in fifth grade, you have more responsibilities, but you also get more privileges, and we do a lot of team activities, we do a lot of building within the grade level. There are lots of fun activities that you can be part of, student council. What else do we do, kids? Lockers are always a joy, lockers are a good time in fifth grade. Changing classes, going from room to room without adults monitoring everything that you do, as long as you earn that responsibility and that right.
So what you can expect when you come to fifth grade is that there's going to be more work, more independence, and a lot more choices in the classes that you can take. You're going to be introduced to a language class, going to be doing some health classes, and you'll be changing teachers a lot during the day, so it's an exciting time for kids when they come over from the elementary school.
All right, so when the fourth graders come and our fifth graders in PE, I think that the biggest difference is they have phys ed every other day, all year long. We expose our kids to a wide variety of physical activities, and they need to come with a positive attitude and have their sneakers every day ready to go.
Hi, Mrs. Tessinero. One thing that I think is important that fifth graders realize when they come to the middle school is that they're certainly going to have more freedom than they're used to at the elementary school. That's the first thing. The second thing is when they're walking to classes, they walk on their own. They're not escorted. And they need to walk quietly and orderly and not run like they're on an playground. When they get into exploratory classes, again, there's more freedom. It's important that they have that, but I think they need to realize, again, they're still in a classroom, and they will understand the guidelines and the constraints of each of the classrooms once they get here. And I think they're going to enjoy the fact that they have the freedom, but keep in mind that there are rules they have to follow.
I am Ms. Boland, and I teach health to 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. And this year, the students have health for a quarter of the year, but they have it for half of the year because they go to me one day, and the day that they don't go to me, they go to physical education. And in health class, we do a lot of different things. We start out and we talk about self-esteem, and we have some practice in sort of advanced decision making. And then we go and we start to talk about tobacco, and we get what I call smart about tobacco. And then from there, we talk about ways to say no, assertiveness skills, so you can actually feel comfortable saying no. And then sometimes we end with plays, and we apply some of that knowledge that we've been working on. So that's about it.
Oh, welcome, fourth graders, to the Monument Valley Library. When you're here in fifth grade, you'll be working on some research projects, and you'll also be picking wonderful reading books out of our great selection. And you'll have time during your free time to come and explore the library, work on your homework, or work on projects. I look forward to working with you.
In fifth grade art, we get to use a lot of interesting supplies and art mediums that you may have not used before. You get a lot of choice in fifth grade art, and we explore the principles of design and elements of art quite a bit.
Hello there, fourth graders. I am Madame Elliott, which means Mrs. Elliott, and I will be your French teacher in fifth grade. And I'm looking forward to it. You'll have French for about a quarter of the year, and the idea is for you to check it out, see if you like French, see if you like the foreign language experience, and then later on when you're in seventh grade, you can decide to take French or Spanish. So you might want to know, well, what is this French class all about? Because you haven't had any French so far, most of you. Well, in French class, we do a lot of work with important props like this fish. This is le poisson méchant, which means the mean fish. And I use a lot of stuffed animals to help teach things like vocabulary, word order, adjective agreement, all that fun stuff, which is way more fun if you use animals than if you use worksheets. My class is very interactive. We move around a lot. We stand up, sit down, sit on the floor. And it involves mostly speaking and listening. So you'll be listening, speaking, and then some reading and writing, but really mostly speaking and listening. And if you haven't ever heard of Tintin or Asterix, I know some of you have, you'll be introduced to two very important comic characters in the French-speaking world, Tintin or Tintin. You probably already know about him now because Steven Spielberg is coming out with a movie, which is very exciting. Those were all written in French. Those are French classics, not to be confused with American classics like Snoopy. They're French classics. So we learn a little bit about those and watch a few Tintin videos and read a few Tintin books and generally do a lot of stuff like that. But the key is we don't do it in English. We do it en français. I think you'll have a good time. You just have to relax. Pay attention, go with the flow, and you'll be very successful in the class. I really look forward to seeing you next year. Oh, and did you see my mug? It's a sha-sha-sha mug. It's all different cats with names in French. All right, au revoir!
So, fifth graders, actually soon to be fifth graders, when you get into music next year, you're going to be doing a lot of different activities that you don't do this year. You're going to be studying instruments. That's probably pretty much what you're going to be doing. You're going to be studying what the families of instruments are, how they're related. You're going to hear different pieces of music that use different instruments. And you're all going to actually make your own homemade musical instrument as one of your project. You're going to use the classroom instruments and create your own themes. And you're going to really know everything there is to know about musical instruments by the end of fifth grade. So I look forward to seeing you.
Hola, yo soy Señor Heath. I'm Mr. Heath, a Spanish teacher. And in the fifth grade, you can expect to have Spanish and French for 45 days, for one marking period. And in Spanish class, in la clase de Español, practicamos el Español. We practice a little bit of Spanish, and we learn some new vocabulary, and we get you ready for the seventh grade. when you can take it for a full year. Hasta luego.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Lavoy, and I'm the principal and vice principal secretary. So if you would like to meet with either of them, you come to see me. If you need extra copies of anything,
I can help you out with that too.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Duffin. I'm the guidance secretary here at Monument Valley, and if you need help with your schedule or if you need to see guidance counselor or the adjustment counselor, come to see me.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Congdon, and I'm the assistant principal here at Monument Valley. And what you need to know about my role in the school is my job is to keep the school safe for everyone. The school will belong to you once you come here as a student, and you should feel that you can come to me if there's a problem that you're not sure of. Maybe it's with a friend who's not treating you well or that is excluding you from things, because part of my role is to make sure that bullying does not take place at our school. And if I don't know about it, then I can't do anything about it. So I'd like to make the school fun for you, safe for you, want you to have a good time, and I'm here for really anything that you need. So can't wait to see you.
We work really closely with Muddy Brook to make sure that students transition from fourth grade to fifth grade is as supported, as exciting, is as open and understandable as possible. We start way back in fourth grade. I know that there's conversations between the two schools, and I know that there's a visit by the fourth graders over to Monument Valley. The transition from fourth grade to fifth grade is huge. It's no longer in a classroom with one teacher is going out to specials, but it's actually coming and having different teachers for all your different subjects, a schedule, and of course, the big thing, the locker. So also we spend some time over the summer. Students come in with their families to really see what the school is about, even though they came over in fourth grade and had a day with us in the spring. It's really important in the summer when now they're officially out of elementary school to come and see the middle school. And the big thing on the day when they come in is the locker and the combination, which really, I think, settles students and makes them feel like they're part of our community and part of our world. The first few weeks of fifth grade are also really important. The fifth grade team is amazing, great teachers, great staff, and they try and make kids really feel like they're part of it and they're welcome, and making them feel like they're part of the family. So the transition from fifth grade from the summer is really important, like I was saying. What's really important is that the teachers take a lot of time to do the transition, to make sure that students understand, get organized in all their different classes, and really take the time to have community activities, to build relationships, not only between the teachers and the kids, but also between the kids. It really is a big thing to come into a fifth grade, but also a building that has fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth grade. The year is really spent making the transition to middle school, so by the time they finished fifth grade, they're really ready for sixth and really understand what it means to spend 4 years in Monument Valley. So all in all, we care a lot about the transition. We care a lot about kids being prepared and feeling like they're part of a family and part of a community here in Monument Valley.
Now, school is awesome. Middle school is really cool because you have lots of freedom.
One of the best parts of middle school is you get your own locker.
Middle school is certainly very different from elementary school.
You have more time to hang out with your friends.
You have more teachers because you switch classes often.
There's more books at the library so you can read them. Yay!
It's radical!
I like gym because of all the action we do in gym class.
The lockers are really cool in middle school.
Better classes.
School is amazing.
School's good so far.
I think that school's inspiring for what you want to do in later life.
I love school because everyone's really nice and it's a great environment.
I love this school because the food is so good.
I like school because it's fun and I get to see my friends.
School is amazingly awesome.
We like school because you get a lot of freedom.
Hi! School is absolutely fantabulous!
Yeah. Fall is here, hear the yell. Back to school, ring the bell. Brand new shoes, walking blues. Climb the fence, books and pens. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell.